Welcome, dear learners, to massive open online course on research in technical education. Dear learners, we have already learned how to select a research problem. Now, in this video, we will learn how to define a research problem and how to write research questions or formulate the objectives. Now, the question is, why defining the research problem? Dear learners, as you begin a journey, you need to know your destination. So, defining your destination before beginning a journey is very important. Likewise, before you carry out research work, you need to define your research problem, as the defining of research problem determines what research is intended, how it is to be intended, will it withstand systematic and scientific inquiry, how you will do it, and what you may achieve. So, let us understand the steps required in defining research problem and writing research question. The first step is formulate initial research question, which is quite global. Then review the literature based on initial question, that is, try to throw light on the theoretical framework, the methodology, the data collection method, the tools, etc., and then outline the gaps in the previous research. While outlining gaps, avoid its duplication. And the last step is refining research question based upon what is the scope of your research question, and if necessary, analyze the research question into sub question. There could be number of sub question or number of objectives for a research problem. Now, writing and defining a research problem. Dear learners, a problem which is clearly stated is a problem half solved, because you know in advance what to do and what not to do while carrying out research. Stating the problem can be in the question form, or it can be in the form of a declarative or descriptive sentence. Let me give you one example. Question form: what effect has the computer assisted instruction had on the knowledge and skills acquisition of digital electronics at degree level? Now, the same topic can be stated in the form of a sentence. A study of effect of computer assisted instruction on the knowledge and skill acquisition of digital electronics at degree level. Secondly, try to write the definition of the problem as clearly and specifically as possible. So, try to avoid unnecessary words. Another is avoid value statements, words like ought, better than, should, poor, because these convey personal or cultural bias. Now, for example, should mechanical engineering students be involved in an industrial attachment scheme? So, the better way is, what effect does an industrial attachment scheme have on performance of students in a mechanical engineering course? Likewise, avoid dichotomous question which can be answered either yes or no, agree, disagree, right or wrong. For example, do mechanical engineering students need an industrial attachment period included in their training course? Avoid problems related to moral and ethical issues, like are remedial classes bad for engineering graduates? Avoid topics on philosophical issues, what is meant by democracy, and avoid topics on theological issues, which religious group you belong, because these cannot be researched, these can be discussed. Now, writing research question, you have the broad question, analyze the question into different components. For example, are the fitting and machining skills of mechanical degree holders up to the skill level required by local industry? Now, you analyze this broader question and you will come to know there are three components. One is skills of mechanical degree holders, skill required by the industry and similarities between the two. Now, based upon these three components, you can write three research questions. What level of fitting and machining skills are being taught in the institution A? What level of fitting and machining skills are required by local industry in community A? Is there a difference between what is taught and what is needed by industry in terms of fitting and machining skills? You can also write research question based upon the variables you are going to include in your study. So, review variables. For example, the topic is, what are the impacts of linkages existing between a technical institute and the industry for the implementation of institutional program? Now, you can determine two types of variable, the impact, which may include the employment, curriculum content, skill performance, facilities, and the second is the linkages, that is on the job training, funding, communication. Now, based upon these two variables, you can write two research questions. One is, what funding linkages exist between Technical Institute A and industry, and what communication linkages exist between Technical Institute A and industry? And then another way of writing research question is by thinking about the hunches or guesses of results. For example, the topic is, what is the effect of multimedia on the performance of degree students in teaching cloud computing? Now, the hunches could be that students may be more motivated by multimedia. Secondly, multimedia may better explain some cloud computing concepts. So, based upon these two hunches, we can write two research questions. One is, will multimedia significantly motivate degree students, or will multimedia significantly provide a more effective means of instruction than non-use? Now, for stating the objectives, you need to know the SMART guidelines. The objective should be stated very specifically using action verb. Try to avoid general statement. The objective should be measurable, so there should be a specified outcome. It should be achievable, that is, be realistic. It should be well within one's reach. It should be realistic, that is, you can anticipate the problems, consider various factors, money, time, skills to do what you wish to do, and whether you have access to sensitive information, subjects, consent, etc. And the last one is the time constraint, so try to maintain the time schedule. Now, let us take one topic and see what could be the objectives. Effect of video assisted instruction and computer based concept mapping on achievement in mathematics in relation to emotional intelligence and attitude towards technology. Now, for this problem statement, you can think of number of objectives: to study the effect of different instructional strategies on achievement of students in mathematics, or to study the differences in achievement of students in mathematics with different levels of emotional intelligence, to study the differences in achievement of students in mathematics with different levels of attitude towards technology, to study the interactional effect of instructional strategies and emotional intelligence on achievement in mathematics, to study the interactional effect of instructional strategies and attitude towards technology on achievement in mathematics, to study the interactional effect of emotional intelligence and attitude towards technology on achievement in mathematics, and to study the interactional effect of instructional strategies, emotional intelligence, and attitude towards technology on achievement in mathematics. So, dear learners, defining a research problem plays a very important role in the conduct of research study. After defining the research problem, you need to write research questions, and you need to write the objectives of the research problem. Thank you very much.